Well, we've got to acknowledge that in spite of this evidence, the fossil evidence, Darwin did not give up on his theory of evolution. And what he proposed, we want to look at next. So here's our next clip I want you folks to watch.
Darwin was deeply troubled by the Cambrian explosion. He called it an inexplicable mystery. But he wasn't about to abandon his theory and instead proposed that the animals just looked like they appeared suddenly because he thought that the fossil record was incomplete.
I look at the natural geological record as a history of the world imperfectly kept and written in a changing dialect. Of this history, we possess the last volume alone, relating only to two or three countries. Of this volume, only here and there a short chapter has been preserved, and of each page, only here and there a few lines.
So Darwin argued, well, perhaps paleontological discovery, digging through the rocks, needed more time, that the transitions were out there, that not enough collecting had occurred, not enough sampling, if you will, of the fossil record on Earth, and given time, those transitions would turn up.
All right, Stephen, if Darwin was waiting for new fossil discoveries to solve the mystery of the missing ancestor fossils, what have the new discoveries in paleontology shown us?
Well, that's the really remarkable thing, and that's what's so significant about the Burgess Shale, the great discovery that was made in Western Canada in the early part of the 20th century. New fossils have turned up, but rather than ameliorating or eliminating the mystery of the Cambrian explosion, they've actually made the mystery more acute, because what the new fossil finds have shown, both in the Burgess Shale and also other fossil finds, in particular one in China, what these new finds have shown is that there were many more Cambrian animals, complex animals, that arose in the Cambrian period than even Darwin knew. And so the explosion was, if you will, more explosive than he understood. And for each of these new forms of Cambrian animal life that arose, each of these were in turn lacking discernible ancestors in the lower strata. So whereas before you had a pattern with a group of complex animals arising, each of which was lacking ancestors in the lower strata, now you have an even wider array of new complex animal forms arising abruptly, again, with each of those new forms missing ancestors. So you're looking at an even more explosive pattern as a result of these new discoveries.
Yeah, and even as you said in your book, okay, Darwin's Doubt, you said even a child can look and see that these animals that just appeared are different, they're more complex, or they're very complex. They're really something to look at.
Well, it might be helpful for your audience to get a sense of just how dramatic this event is in the history of life, because there are about 36 phyla, and a phylum is the largest division of animal classification. So there are about 36 phyla in the history of life. About 26 or 27 of those phyla are fossilized, and of those that are fossilized, fully 20 of the phyla first appear in the Cambrian. There are representatives of those phyla that first appear in the Cambrian period. So this is a big event in the history of life. A lot of the new form and structure, the new body plans that have existed on planet Earth first arrived during that period of time, and they do so very abruptly without clear connections to ancestral forms in the lower strata.
That's why they call it a Cambrian explosion. It's boom, it's there.